Well, they've been throwing on their 90s and sliding into their dad's slippers and mind frames for years, all for a bit of a laugh.
Keep me cash.
Keep me dash of hand.
Keep me crab apple.
Tom handkerchief.
Tom a plank.
Lamb shanks.
Arnold Schwarzer trigger.
Arnold the snitch on the burger.
Almond the Schwarzer pickles.
Doggy doggy.
Snappy doggy doggy.
Snoopy poppy.
Superb. And now the boys are back for an encore tour and they join us in the studio. Gents, such a pleasure to have you
so
in here
nice.
Again.
Yeah. Nice to be back.
So good to be back.
This tour has been unbelievable. It started off with 7 dates, grew to 38 days, and now you're doing a victory tour.
Don't tell the tax department because I don't know.
And a third Rod Laver Arena show.
Third Rod Laver Arena. I know, we're a bit surprised ourselves.
Yeah. Not bad for a bunch of blokes who can't read or write.
That's right. That's right.
Just cash in hand as well.
Yeah,
for the tickets. Got you.
Cash
brown
the
paper
door,
bag.
Cash at the door.
You guys have been such a blessing over the pandemic, over the past couple of years. You've given us so much entertainment online, but is it so good to be back in front of live audiences? It makes a difference, right?
Yeah, of course. It's absolutely amazing, you know. Having that live reaction is good. I mean, the online stuff is nice, but, just to be able to hear the roar is good.
Yeah. It's instant
faces.
Feedback.
See you guys.
Yes.
It's touching.
Yes.
It's great. I love it.
But he's a smash in everything. It's so great to see he's doing so well. You've got a new podcast now as well, isn't it? Can you tell us about Sushi Meatballs?
It's called the Sushi Mango Saucy Meatballs Podcast. We thought we'd condense
it. A podcast, not about meatballs.
It's not about meatballs.
Okay, all right.
We've had lots of guests on. We had the Prime Minister. We've had recently had Coolio. We had
Tina Arena.
Oh, wow.
And we even had a controversial figure, Mick Gatto.
What?
Yeah, we had
Nick
Gatto.
Oh, wow.
We're on our bestest behaviour for that one.
So if you're ever out of line, we know some people.
Andy Lee's come on. I mean, we've got a bunch of great guests. Hey, you guys are going to come on when you're in Melbourne.
We'd love to. We won't leave you with concrete boots. In fact, the Prime Minister, you interviewed him. We've got a little bit of that. Let's have a look.
Mr. Scotch Lamington, it's a very important question for all of Australia and Australia people. You can't take them off of this tax, please.
Which tax are you guys referring to?
All tax.
Every tax.
All of it. Tax off, tax on.
Like that man from Japan. A tax on, a tax off.
No, we're taking tax off.
A good tax off.
That's good. We're putting the taxes down.
Tax off. Not down, off.
You should keep more of what you earn.
That's right.
That's good. We love you, Lamington.
I can stop a bit of cash in my backyard. Now. That's
very good.
Wow, how was that?
It was really good. We should have told him not to tackle teenagers.
Guess what? He wasn't a teenager. He was 8 years old.
Well, there you go.
Well, minus.
Yeah, it's all right. Yeah.
That was crazy, you know. It was weird.
There he is.
He's coming off there. There you go. That's the way to play soccer.
there's another angle. There we go. There we go.
Hey. Took him out.
Vote one, ScoMo.
Now, as Italians, you guys know a thing or two about food. What are your thoughts on ScoMo's famous Indian curries that he puts together?
I tell you, I heard the next day it was a bit horrific.
If it looks that way going in, imagine going out.
It looks a bit like puppy vomit, doesn't it?
It does.
Hey, can I just tell you guys, every time we come here, can you fix this chair situation? Remember last time? It's not good for a guy my height. I told you guys.
Do you need a footstool or something?
Yeah, I'm going to sit on the step next time. This is ridiculous.
Hey, is there a fun story behind your name? Because we've been chatting to you guys for ages. Where did Sushi Mango come from?
I give credit to Joe Stunker.
Well, my son was saying sushi. He was about 3 years old at the time. And he was saying sushi mango. And we were sitting down saying, well, we're going to call this thing that we're doing here. And he was on the toilet saying sushi mango.
I believe he was doing number two.
So we were saying, what are we going to call this thing? And he's going, sushi mango. And I'm like, buddy, just trust for a second. We're trying to think of this. And then we're saying, what's sushi mango? And I go, buddy, please, come up there. Just trust for one sec. And we're sushi mango. And I'm like to my wife, can you get your son, please?
And then that's why I said, hey, that sounds about as stupid as us. Let's just take that name. So that's how it came about.
Well, Sushi Mango derives from a three-year-old taking a crap.
Yeah. good ideas come from shit. Yeah.
Speaking of which, do you have any kind of predictions on who we might see as our next Prime Minister tomorrow?
Ooh, I'm thinking it might be... I don't know.
Yeah. You spoke to Scott Morrison. We know that Anthony Albanese is a proud Italian-Australian.
Yes.
I always wonder, why is there only talk about two people getting it when there's all these other people?
Major parties, yeah. There's been a huge rise of the Teal independents.
I think that we should run next year.
Sushi Banger for Prince.
Next time, yeah.
Some nonnas in the Senate, maybe.
We have some good policies and stuff like that, I reckon, we could bring to the party.
Yeah, first, what would the first policy be?
The pasta for everyone. Hey!
Another one we could replace Labor Day with Salami Day.
We're down. You guys are absolutely awesome. Sushi Mango Off the Boat, the Victory Lap are back in August and September across the country. Head to tegdainty.com for tickets and tour info. Thanks so much for coming again.
It's always great to see you.
Hey!
Stick up
your
hand. It'll be right back. So right.